Researchers predict the global energy consumption along with its associated CO2 emission will increase by at least 25% over the next 50 years. With increasing energy demand and awareness of global warming, the entire energy market is trying to transition from fossil fuels to renewable energy such as wind and solar power. Although the renewable energy sources are much more sustainable and environmentally friendly, they do suffer from an intrinsic intermittency. That is, their power output not only depends on location, but also time of the year or even time of the day. This results in an imbalance between the supply and demand in electricity. But what if we can build a giant battery that stores electricity when there's energy surplus and releases energy when there's energy deficit? This brings us to my research. My name is Yingjie, you can call me Jay. I'm a fourth-year PhD student at the Department of Chemistry at the U of A. My research primarily focuses on developing catalysts for battery applications, specifically zinc-air batteries. In addition to being low-cost and extremely safe, zinc-air batteries can store four times as much energy as the current lithium-ion batteries. This benefits make zinc-air batteries an ideal candidate for stationary energy storage. However, the chemical reactions inside the zinc-air batteries are very slow. This lowers the potential and power available to the external device, also known as potential and power output. Therefore, current zinc-air batteries require platinum ruthenium as catalysts to speed up the reactions and increase the potential and power output. But the high cost and scarcity of this precious metal greatly impede the large-scale commercialization of zinc-air batteries. My project is to design and produce efficient and cost-effective catalysts as an alternative. The alternative catalyst I produced is a hybrid between holomesoporous carbon nanospheres, or HMC in short, and manganese oxide nanoparticles, both of which are much cheaper than the platinum ruthenium. Here is their electron microscopic image. The holostructure of the HMC and the nanoscale size of the manganese oxide nanoparticles maximize the effective surface area of the hybrid, which ensures maximum interaction between the catalyst and the reactants inside the battery. To evaluate catalysts in zinc-air batteries, we look at their potential and power output. When a catalyst is incorporated into the battery, higher potential and power output indicate a better catalyst, which we found here with the hybrid in comparison to the original HMC and the precious metal platinum ruthenium. We also found that the hybrid showed a minimal discharge potential drop after 120 hours of cycling, indicating a highly stable material. This means that the battery can be recharged many times while still maintaining the same amount of energy storage capacity. In conclusion, not only does this hybrid catalyst reduce the cost of zinc-air batteries dramatically, but it also exhibits higher potential and power output, as well as superior stability than their precious metal counterpart. This is an important step in making renewable energies more feasible and make sure we have the energy we need without the carbon dioxide we don't. Thank you for listening.